The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
All right, let's do this. Hey, what's up,
Yeah,
everybody? Hey, man, Clay, what's up, dude? How are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How are you doing, Pat?
I'm doing awesome. Everyone who's listening or actually watching right now, thank you so much for coming on to the webinar, to this workshop. It's going to be awesome. We just did one last night, over a little over 12 hours ago, and the response was so amazing. We learned a lot, Clay and I. So we're going to give you the best presentation we can. There are 526, 527 people here so far. So I mean, I know you're at on a computer or maybe on your phone right now, by yourself or with your coworkers. Maybe you're watching this at work. And if you are, thank you. Don't tell your boss on me. But just imagine a room with like almost 600 people in it. And I mean, it's just, I am so humbled by the fact that you're here watching. It's just this is just so crazy. I just want to know, who's here. So if you wanted to chat, I mean, you won't be able to see everyone else's comments or whatever, but if you go to the questions panel, just type in, where you're from. I'd love to know where you're from, and I'll see if I can send any names. San Diego, Colby, what's up? Houston, Texas, Reba, San Antonio, Malcolm. We got people from the UK, a bunch of people from the UK. I guess this is the right time for them, for those of you over the pond. Shout out to, gosh, where did all those UK ones go? Yanis and Raman, Rob from Sonoma, California, Nashville, Houston, Dayton, Studio City, Eric, Layla, Maudie, Addison, Jen. Wow, okay, there are way too many comments here. I will not be able to say everybody's name. Brazil, but living in
Armenia,
Orlando. Yeah, this
Belgium.
is awesome. Curtis, Rose, Dustin, Sheldon, what's up, everybody? Madeline, Lee, Arena, John. Probably best for me to say, common name. So, like John and Michael. But there is a Michael from Germany. Just thank you guys so much for coming on. This is so awesome. And before we get started, I just wanted to sort of give you the lowdown on what to expect. I mean, we're gonna do probably an hour and a half of content. I mean, this stuff is really good stuff. I've even actually, since last night's webinar, I have stayed up late to implement some of these things already. And Clay has some really good tips for how to take what you listen in this webinar, or what you hear or see in this webinar, and how to apply it. But I just we just want to set the expectations. There's going to be a ton of content, but on top of that, we have some special things for you for being on live. There's going to be some giveaways, so make sure you stay on. And of course, you're seeing the logo here for LeadPages. That is a company that I am fallen in love with recently. Clay is the co-founder, and I am actually, and just for full transparency, I am an advisor of the company. And we are going to be sharing content today, but we're also going to be going into the LeadPages software. And I think it was really funny on last night's webinar. Clay was trying really hard to not make it sound pitchy. I mean, he didn't sound pitchy at all, but I could tell that he was really weary about the words that he was using, because he knows the kind of audience that you are, and you've been pitched plenty before. But I think you're on this. I mean, you're going to get content, but there's going to be an offer for lead pages at the end with a bonus too. So again, I just want to be upfront. There's no fooling here. But whether you get lead pages or not, and I know a lot of you already have it, which is cool too. The principles behind the tips that Clay is going to give is so important. And even if you don't get lead pages, you can implement all of this stuff. So I consider that. And Clay, so you have my permission, Clay, just to not worry about sounding pitchy. I mean, obviously don't sell, because I think the software will sell itself. But I mean, that's not the point of this. The point of this is to provide content and also share this amazing piece of software that I've fallen in love with recently. But yeah, I just wanted to say that up front. Thank you guys so much. I'm getting a lot of great comments from people just saying, just do it. Daniel's asking, is this live? Yes, it's live, and that should prove it. Yeah, people are just like, do what you got to do. I got lead pages. You better share it with everybody. Yeah, this is great. So again, I just wanted to set those expectations up front. So Clay, let me hand over the mic to you really quick, and just say hi to everybody, and take it from there.
Yeah, awesome. Well, thanks for that intro. And just to what you're saying, yeah, the date is right here. So it's Friday. I live in Minneapolis, Minnesota. So it's Friday at 1:06 p.m. And I have a feeling it's going to be like painfully obvious that this is live, because accidents do happen, especially on live webinars. And to just kind of to the point of what Pat was saying, a lot of people that are that follow Pat are also LeadPages customers, and I realize that. So my aim here is to provide as much value as possible to both groups, to people who don't use lead pages. We're going to talk about how to do this stuff without lead pages. And to people who do use lead pages, I will be going into the app and showing and just showing you how to do some of these things. So I don't want to exclude lead pages customers, but I don't want to exclude non-lead pages customers either. So everything we're going to talk about, the principles are just solid marketing principles that work across the board. Both groups of people are going to absolutely get value. I also want to say that my voice is rapidly going, so hopefully I'll still be able to say something by the time we're done. So today's webinar is called The 7 Most Important Tweaks You Can Make to Your Website to 3 to 4X Your List in the Next 6 Months. And I kind of shared this story on the podcast with Pat, but back in the day, we had this goal, and this is kind of the birth of this webinar and this kind of journey that I've been on. But back in the day, I wanted to double our revenue as a business, and I started thinking about the different ways to do that. And one way that we thought of to do that was to double the amount of traffic that we get to our website. And we wanted to do this in like a month. And we wanted to double our revenue in a month. And so I set about trying to double our traffic. And we weren't in a place where we could pay for it, like a lot of people, a lot of people aren't in a place to pay for traffic. So we started doing SEO. We did more social media. We upped the number of blog posts that we did, started interviewing people. And we bumped up our traffic a little bit, but mostly it was an uphill battle. And we grew our traffic about 15%, but it was difficult. So, you know, I guess in theory, you can double your revenue by doubling the amount of traffic that you get. But for us, it was very difficult to do that in a short period of time. So then the next strategy that we turned to in an effort to double our revenue and to increase our revenue was, I thought, well, maybe if all things being equal, we can double the amount, we can double the conversion rate on our sales pages, then we can double our revenue. So if the traffic stays the same, but the conversion rate on our sales pages doubles, then we can double our revenue. So I went out, I went about to do that. And I kind of went into my text editor and I was going to like rewrite the sales page and stuff. And after a few minutes, I was just like, ugh, like I just didn't want to rewrite it. Like I'm the kind of person where after I've done something the first time, especially with sales copy, I just don't want to do it again. So I quickly determined that that wasn't going to be the way that we doubled the conversion rate or that we doubled our revenue. So then my next thought was, what if our traffic stays the same and the conversion rate on our sales page stays the same, but we can double the percentage of people that show up on our opt-in pages who end up opting in? So we could actually like effectively double the growth of our list. And that's sort of what we did. I stayed up one night. I spent about 40 minutes tweaking with our main opt-in page. And the next day, we had effectively doubled the conversion rate on that opt-in page. It actually wasn't that hard to do. We ended up doubling our revenue that month purely because we doubled the percentage of people that showed up on our opt-in pages who ended up opting in. So I was like, wow, this is really cool. What if I could add more opt-in pages? And what if I could go to our other websites and hone and refine those opt-in pages and add more opt-in pages and offer more people higher value things in exchange for them opting in? What would happen? And so I just systematically did this in our business. And we ended up not just doubling our revenue that first month, but we doubled it the next month. And then we doubled it after the month after that. And so we actually effectively almost doubled our revenue 4 months in a row. The fourth month, it was about a 15x. But then the next month, we got to 22x. So we effectively 22x'd our revenue by doing this. And I'm just going to show you, this is just really a hands-on presentation. I'm just going to kind of just show you what I did. So I'm just going to show you like the landing pages and what we offered and sort of like the principles behind what we did. So I'm just going to kind of get to all that. So I want everyone to know that this is, like we talked about earlier, this is a live webinar. So please do enter in your questions as, as soon as you think of them. We're going to try and answer every single major type of question. There are hundreds upon hundreds of people on the webinar live right now, so I can't promise that I'll individually be able to answer every question, but we're going to try and answer every single major type of question. In order to answer the questions, just enter it in the question box right there. And I know Pat's been doing a good job, I think, of it, picking up and answering some questions as he thinks of them, or as he sees them.
People are leaving questions, and I'm answering as we go in the chat box. So I'm doing my best too. There's a ton of them coming in, so if I don't get to you, I apologize. But we're trying our best.
Awesome. So we're going to run for about an hour and a half, and I want you to get out your notepad and write down action items, right? So try to avoid writing down like cute sayings or stuff that's in quotes interesting. I want to encourage you or challenge you to only write down stuff that you're actually going to do in the next 24 to 48 hours. So I think a lot of times people get on webinars and they treat them as like entertaining experiences, and they write a lot of stuff down and they feel like they've accomplished something. And I think that's fine, but I want to challenge you to only write down things that you're going to do and to really think about, how you're going to implement this quickly, because a lot of the things I'm going to share here are things you can do very, very soon. So a little bit about me. I think a lot of times people on these webinars, they have like these long intro things and they go on and on and on about like the cars they have or something like that. And frankly, I don't care about cars. But just one thing about me, I'm the co-founder of a software company called LeadPages. We're not a small company. We're not a large company either. We've got about 18 people on our team, and we're growing. So we're looking to hire a lot more people right now. So if you are a Python developer, please hit me up on Twitter.
I don't even know what that means, but okay.
If you are a Python developer who understands Google App Engine, hit me up on Twitter, and I would love to talk to you. Also, if you're a content marketer, I'm not going to turn this into a pitch session for hiring people, although we are growing. So if you want to work with an awesome team, we're here for you. So anyway, I'm the co-founder of a software company, and we love what we're doing. So without further ado, I'm just going to go over the tweaks that that we're suggesting. So just one by one, we're just going to go into some different things that you can do in your business to, again, I said in the title slide, to 3x to 4x your revenue. We 22x our revenue. Our hope is that just following these things, you can at least 3 to 4x your list growth, which for us resulted in increased revenue. And kind of actually, we talked about this on the podcast, but the effect of growing your list is really viral. Like, we found that when we grew our list, and when there are more people on our list, then every time we emailed everyone about a blog post, more people shared the blog posts on Facebook and Twitter, which meant that more people then joined our list after finding out about us on Facebook and Twitter. And those people, found out about new blog posts. So it was kind of like a viral loop. I think a lot of times people think of viral loops as being things that happen purely on social media. But for us, all viral growth has been kind of old school by email marketing. This is a live webinar, I promise. Okay, so the first tip is that I'm going to suggest you do is to optimize your 404 pages. So
yeah, some of this stuff will overlap with the podcast, but the benefit here is you get to see it and actually see how to implement it too. So I just want to let you know.
I'd say about 30% of this is conceptually like covered in the podcast, but we're going to actually just show you the nitty gritty and like show you the pages and what to do and the copy to use. So tweak number one is to optimize your 404 pages. And so just to get a sense of what a 404 page is, some people don't know. If I just go to Google and I type some crazy stuff, I'll see this 404 page. And a 404 page is basically the page that you are sent when the URL that you're looking for is not found. And so this is kind of a standard 404 page. It says the requested URL, whatever this says, was not found on this server. That's all we know. And the truth is that most of the time when someone goes to your 404 page, the vast majority of people that end up on a 404 page just end up leaving your site and frankly, never coming back again. And we had this experience as a business where we knew that a fairly notable blog was going to link to us. And we were all excited about the date for when this was going to happen. And, you know, I got up one morning and I saw that the post was published and I clicked on the link and it was a 404 page. And I ended up going into my analytics. And my analytics showed me that almost everyone who got that 404 page just left. And frankly, they didn't come back. And it was devastating to us, really. You know, I was trying to get the person on the phone. I was tweeting them. I couldn't find them. But like 4 hours, 5 hours later, we ended up getting them to change the link. But by that time, it was like too late. So we have this really painful experience around people landing on our 404 pages and getting nothing. And also people on social media or, you know, whatever, doing this. So what we did was we instituted a, and I just set up a dummy one, just so you can see, but we instituted a 404 page like this on our blog so that when you get to a 404 page, we don't offer, we're not in the real estate business. I just sort of grabbed a cover here. But when you land on our 404 page, it says something like this. 404, holy smokes, unfortunately, the information you're looking for is unavailable. But wait, don't leave empty-handed. Grab my free report. And then you can like opt in to get a free report. So this is kind of what we've instituted, and it ensures that like literally nobody slips through the cracks of your business. So this is kind of like what we've had up recently when someone goes to our 404 page. It says the page you were looking for could not be found, but don't leave empty-handed. Snag this marketing lesson, and then you know people can opt in here to get this. And you know, this is something that you can hire a custom developer to do. You can That's also, yeah. But you can also do this with LeadPages. So I'm going to go into to LeadPages right now to show this to you.
And you can see what my 404 page looks like by going to smartpassiveincome.com/ and just like bang your head on the keyboard and you'll see my 404 page. And it is, quote, optimized, but it's not collecting emails. And you'll see in a later graphic that Clay will show, I believe, just how many people are visiting the 404 page. So I know a lot of you don't even know what that is, but it's the page that people land on when there's a mistake in the URL. And a lot of people land on this page. So I am going to implement this tip for sure.
Yep. Totally. So I'm going to just show you how you can optimize one of these 404 pages. So if you just go into Lead Pages, you'll see one of the templates that we offer is a 404 page. And so I'm going to click here, and this is for Lead Pages customers. But you can put in your own logo here, or you can swap it out for another one. But let's find it. So I'm going to click here, and it says Lead Pages 404. Holy smokes. The information you're looking for is not found, but don't leave empty-handed. Grab this free ebook, and you know I can change this to say free report. And then you know I can click here if I want, and I'll just show you how to recreate what we did. So I'll just click on. I just uploaded this free, you know, this book report right here. But you can also, you know, if you don't have time to like make a book cover or something like that, you can just grab a copy. You know, you can just grab an image of whatever thing you're giving away, just find the cover and reduce it and paste it right here. But we're going to go back to this. So, you know, I could say like, you know, the screaming deal report. And I could go here and go to images and find this and go ahead and create it. And in terms of integrating with an opt-in form, you know, we work with AWeber, MailChimp, Infusionsoft. You know, these are the ones that we use in our own company, but actually LeadPages supports a lot more than this. So I'm just going to grab one, find this, and we can collect the first name if we want to. We can actually, this is kind of weird, but you can turn any opt-in page in LeadPages into a go-to webinar opt-in or registration page as well, but it wouldn't make sense to make your 404 page a webinar registration page.
We're going to share more about webinars later and actually show you sort of things we did for this particular webinar. Yesterday, yeah, we had over 2,500 people registered, I believe. Today, we had about 1,500. and there are some cool things that happened and that we did, which we're going to share in a later tip. So,
yeah, I mean, so much of that was like viral growth and didn't even like come from your list. It came from like Twitter, which was awesome. So I'm going to put like Pat 404 demo 2, and I'm going to save this. And so this page is now, actually, we just generated it. This page is actually live on the internet. So this is a live page, and it's mobile responsive. So it works on mobile devices as well, which is super important. And I'm going to show you how you can I'm just going to log into my WordPress here for security purposes. I don't want to show you my my login details. Okay, so here I am logged into my WordPress, and to set this up as my 404 page, all I have to do is go into the LeadPages plugin, which LeadPages works with a lot more than just WordPress. And I found the Pat 404 demo page, and all I have to do is click here and set it as my 404 page. So I could set it to be a home page, a normal page, or my 404 page, and I'm going to click publish. And now all of a sudden, when I go to blog.leadpages.net, it shows this as being the 404 page, and someone can opt in. Someone can opt in to get this. So that's super awesome. So that's how that works. But also, if you want, you can publish this, you know, to Facebook. You would probably not want to publish a 404 page to Facebook. Or you can just download the file and put it on your own server. So it's pretty, you know, there's a lot of different ways that you can publish these pages.
Yeah, I think a lot of people tried to do the smartpassiveincome.com/bang on your head thing, and my server is apparently down as a result of that. So thank you guys for all following directions and doing that.
Crashing the server.
Yeah. So it'll be back up soon. This happens when a billion people come on at the same time. Don't apologize. A lot of people are apologizing. That's not your fault. That's just so cool that you guys actually did that.
That's awesome.
You don't hurt your head, though. Cool. All right, we're going to get into webinars. This is awesome. This is so exciting.
Yeah. So the second thing that I recommend you do is start doing webinars. So here's the thing about webinars. Even if not one person ever shows up for your webinar, okay? Let's just pretend, hypothetically, that not one person ever shows up for your webinar. And let's pretend that not one person ever does a deal with you over a webinar or buys anything from you because of a webinar you did. You should still do webinars, because in terms of event-based marketing, nothing across our entire platform, nothing is getting higher opt-in rates than webinar registration pages. Literally, webinar registration pages are outperforming every single major other kind of opt-in page. And I just recently
experienced this. I mean, this is so crazy. And what's cool is when you get people to register for a webinar, they register for your email list at the same time. So then you can have that lead forever.
Yeah, it's super awesome. And super awesome, that's a technical term. But I'm going to show you actually into the back end of LeadPages. This is something that only a few people have seen before. And this isn't available to customers because we generally don't show this data. But if I go into our templates, this is kind of crazy, the analytics. Like in the last hour, I'm not going to go over that. But if I go to one of our registration pages, one of our templates, and we look at the analytics, you can see that this is a webinar registration page. This is actually the one that we used for this webinar. And this webinar registration page is getting an average opt-in rate across everyone who uses this template on LeadPages. It's getting a 52% opt-in rate. That is unheard of. It's very rare for any business to get an opt-in rate of 52% on a landing page or on any kind of opt-in page or a landing page. But to get this on average across the entire platform is just insane. It's really kind of crazy. So webinar registration pages, again, even if nobody ever shows up and even if nobody ever does any deal or does any business with you because of a webinar, you should do them just because they will grow your list so darn quickly. So why webinars? Webinars have really, in terms of event-based marketing, webinars have grown our business and grown our list faster than just about anything we've ever done in terms of event-based marketing. And coaches are doing this, consultants are doing this, info product people are doing webinars, software companies are doing webinars. Basically, across the board, people are doing webinars simply because they work. Like, webinars are not a fad. They are one of the few ways in this day and age to really connect with people. Probably the best way to connect with people is at a live event. And the second best way is on a webinar. Like, when else do you have an hour and a half to spend with some of your favorite people, helping them out, addressing questions, solving their problems? In most cases, you're lucky if they'll watch three minutes of your YouTube video, right? But on a webinar, you really have the opportunity to serve people at a very high level. So again, forget sales, forget people showing up, do them, even if it's just to grow your list. And I'm going to show you a couple examples of webinar registration pages and sort of the best principles or sort of like best practices for getting them to convert. So I'm going to go here to webinar pages, and let's look at this one. And so there's a number of reasons why this kind of webinar registration page works. Let's go ahead and fill it out. Now in LeadPages, you can customize the colors and the fonts and the backgrounds and stuff. But let's pretend this is a webinar we're going to do. So Pat Flynn and Clay Collins present.
And you could set up a webinar page on your own too if you don't have lead pages. You can go to GoToWebinar and they'll actually give you your own registration page. It'll be harder to customize, of course, which is why this tool is so cool and why it was made. But you don't need lead pages to do this. You can create a webinar registration page on your own. And I think there's a tool out there. It doesn't automatically connect to your emails provider and your list. There are tools that do that for you, but LeadPages will do that for you too.
Yeah, I think what's important is that everyone, when you get someone to register for a webinar, that they not just register for your webinar, they actually opt into your list as well. So you want to be able to simultaneously have them sign up for the webinar and sign up for your list so you can communicate with them down the road. So in this one, we're going to click here and we're just going to set this up as a dummy webinar. We'll call it maybe the landing page webinar, something like this. And I'll click here and I'll just put my face here and I'll click here. I'm just clicking here on hostname. I'm going to make it say Clay Collins. And we can customize all of this, but I'm going to go ahead and set up the opt-in form integration. And I'm going to set it up so that when someone opts in, they're not only added to a webinar on GoToWebinar, but they're also added to our email list. So we'll just do this one. And I'm going to click on OK. So this means that when someone opts in, they're added both to the webinar and to this email list. So why is this page? This is one of our highest converting webinar registration pages. In fact, consistently, this is one of the top two in lead pages in terms of how well it performs. And honestly, I've never seen a page beat this one in a split test before. Well, there's one other. The one we use actually is the only one that I've seen beat it ever, including other webinar registration pages. But there's a number of reasons why this converts so well. So the first reason this converts so well is that there's a countdown timer. And we've been putting countdown timers on all of our landing pages. And just universally across the board, adding a countdown timer adds a huge lift to conversions, typically like maybe a 10 to 15% lift, a relative lift in conversions. And the reason for this is that countdown timers add a sense of urgency, right? When you see that countdown timer counting down to a specific time, It makes it very real and apparent that this is actually going to happen. It also makes sort of the time less abstract, right? May 17th is kind of an abstract concept, but 2 days, 6 minutes, and 12 seconds, or 2 days, 6 hours, 12 minutes and 16 seconds, that's very real. We understand what 2 days, 4 hours, 3 minutes and 16 seconds means. Whereas May 17th is like, sometimes I actually forget what the actual day is. So it makes it very real. And, I always kind of joke that if I had a bar, I would totally, no matter what you're doing and what your business is, there's always a reason and a way to put a countdown timer on it. So like if I owned a bar, I'd have a countdown timer in the morning that counted down to when the bar opened. And I just put it like in the window so people driving by could see it. And then once it opened, I'd have the countdown timer going until when happy hour starts. And then once happy hour started, I'd have the countdown timer going until when happy hour ended. And then when happy hour ended, I'd have it counting down until when the bar closed to last call, right?
Yeah, last call.
Yep. Yeah, for sure. And then once that happened, I'd start it all over again and have it count down to when the bar opens again. There's so many different ways to incorporate this into what you're doing. So that's one of the reasons why this page converts so well. Another is that it's mobile responsive. So the forms that you get with GoToWebinar aren't mobile responsive, and frankly, they don't convert very well, and they look like everyone else's forms. So just by having things being mobile responsive, you can get a lift by getting that mobile traffic. Another reason why this converts so well is that it has a two-step opt-in process. So here's what I mean by this. Whenever anyone goes to a web page, they're generally making a decision about whether or not it's a giving page or a taking page. And when people go to a webinar registration page or any kind of page and they don't see an opt-in box at first, it feels like a giving page. And then if you only give them the opt-in box when they've asked for it, right? Only when they've asked for it, that's just a lot more polite thing to do. And so we found across the board, going from a web page where the opt-in box is immediately there to a web page where they have to click on a button in order to get it, we found that adding this two-step opt-in process adds about a 30% relative lift in conversions. And there's a number of reasons for that. The first reason is that it takes people up a yes ladder, right? If people say yes to clicking on this button, the likelihood that they'll say yes to opting in is much greater, right? So it's kind of like it builds up this commitment inertia. If someone commits to clicking on a button, they're much more likely to commit at a higher level by opting in. So if you can get someone to say yes at a low level of commitment, then you can sort of escalate to a higher level of commitment. It also brings the decision to a head, right? On most pages where the opt-in box is there from the beginning, people can kind of ignore it. They can browse around the page and just kind of ignore the opt-in box and leave. But the second someone clicks here, they have to make a decision one way or another. And make a note of this. The reason almost everyone is not on your list is because they haven't made a decision one way or another about whether or not they want to be on your list, right? Everyone who doesn't make a decision about being on your list isn't on your list, but some percentage of the people who do make a decision about whether or not to be on your list are on your list. So if you could get the entire world to make a decision one way or another about whether or not they wanted to be on your email list, you'd probably have the biggest email list in the world, right? Now, the vast majority of people would not join, but even if a small fraction of the people who made a decision about you, you would have a much bigger list. So adding this two-step opt-in process really helps. Another reason why this converts so well is because we have the only integration that I know of with GoToWebinar where you can allow people to opt in for a webinar with just their email address. So if I turn off the first name here, you can see you can opt in and register for a webinar with just your email address. Now, Pat does this, and I think it's good for some people, and it really depends on your business model. But some people like to accept the first name. But there's a correlation, there's an inverse correlation between the number of fields you ask for and the opt-in rate. So the more fields you ask for, the lower your opt-in rate gets. And with GoToWebinar, kind of out of the box, you need to ask for, they require you to ask for with their pages, first name, last name, and email address. So that's three fields. So when we turn that off and we go from three fields to only one field, the opt-in rate increases. So that's another thing that's going on with this kind of page. And it's really cool, and we're really proud of how this performs. Let's go create a, I'm not going to save this page. I'm just going to exit out. But let's create.
So think about the principles there really quick. Yeah. I mean, just to recap, I mean, beyond LeadPages, just the two-step opt-in process and how powerful that is. And it makes complete sense when people, you know, come to your page. It's not a taking page. It's a giving page. It's content. And then people ask permission to sign up for something. Then they have to make a decision one way or another. So, of course, opt-ins are going to increase that way. And that's something I'm definitely going to be testing. I know a lot of people are using that now. I know Lewis House does that on lewishouse.com. It's a two-step opt-in process. And I haven't talked to him about how well it's doing. But it is, you know, it makes complete sense. So whether you're doing webinars or just getting people to subscribe to your opt-in form, you know, the principles of a two-step process work. If you don't have lead pages, you could do a link that opens a new page,
yep,
or a banner on the side that opens another page where, you know, a landing page you create where people only have one decision to make. So just keep that in mind.
Yep, totally, totally. And you can, you know, you can always hire a developer to code some of this stuff or see if you can find a script online or something like that. Let's kind of recreate the webinar registration page that Pat and I made. So let me see if I can find, where's, here we are. That's us. Look at those two handsome fellows. So
yeah, this is the page we use. You saw this, yep, and this is exactly how I created it. And it was a two-step process, so you were a part of that. And so it worked on you since you're here. So I just hope you can see how kind of really cool that is.
Yeah.
And Clay's going to go over why this particular page works really well.
Yep. So I'm going to go here and add the integration to one of our lists, and I'm going to turn on the GoToWebinar integration. So we'll integrate that there. And one thing that's cool about this, and one of the reasons why this page works so well, is one, that it doesn't have a lot of copy on it. There isn't a lot to, you know, to judge. And sometimes I think people feel the need to really, really explain themselves, and they write a whole lot on their webinar registration pages. And one of the reasons why this is the highest converting page on lead pages is really that we don't even let a lot of people, like, you can't add a lot of copy. I mean, you can if you want to. It's fairly flexible. But in a lot of ways, we've restricted what you can do with this because we want to force people to get good opt-in rates with this page in particular. But one of the things that's really driving opt-ins here is this blurred out mind map. All right. So this is really cool. What people do is they see this mind map and they see a number of items that are blurred out. So they can kind of, there's enough there that they can try and guess about what's on the mind map, but it's blurred out enough that they can't actually see what's on the mind map. So a lot of people will opt in just out of curiosity, like just to know what's on the freaking mind map. And we're going to send everyone the mind map after this presentation. So you will get the mind map that we promised you. But just doing this kind of thing alone can really help out. And again, this is a two-step opt-in process. And, you know, we can change the fonts and colors and stuff like that. I'm not a graphic designer, so I don't have a good sense of how to do that. But webinar page demo. Okay, so I'm going to save this page. And you guys saw how you could publish a page to WordPress. Now I'm going to show you how you can publish a page to Facebook. So again, you can take the file and you can download it and you can put it on your own server. We'll even host it for you if you want. And we have the fastest server network I've ever seen. We actually have our pages hosted on Google's servers. So we pay Google to put our pages on their servers. I'm going to show you how you can publish this to Facebook in, I think, four clicks. Nothing ever goes right on a webinar, but we'll just see if this actually works. So four clicks. So here's one click, two clicks, three clicks, Four clicks. So in four clicks, awesome. So in four clicks, we just added this as a Facebook page. So you can take any page in LeadPages and publish it as a Facebook tab. And as Pat was pointing out yesterday, that this actually gets you, like, Facebook charges you less per click if you're doing Facebook ads. It charges you less if you send traffic within Facebook, right? Like, Facebook wants to eat its own lunch. And you also get higher conversion rates on Facebook traffic when you keep that traffic within Facebook, because a lot of people aren't going to be familiar with your site if you're doing paid Facebook ads, but they are familiar with Facebook. So if you can give them, like, a familiar context to opt into your page, then that really helps. And so that's kind of
Right.
what we do here.
And it doesn't have to be just for webinars. It could be just for getting a free resource, which we'll talk about in a second, or just signing up to your list. And you could drive your own, your own Facebook fans to this page by just simply linking to it. But then what's cool is, like, when they share that, if you provide value and they share it or they like it, their friends will see it. That will get even more people here. So whether you do advertising or not, it's smart to do this as well. Yeah, I mean, if you're paying for ads, it's significantly cheaper to send people from Facebook traffic to Facebook instead of on an external page. And this is how you would do it. And yes, there are ways you can do this. You can use, I think it's a tool called Woobox, which will allow you to put HTML into a Facebook page just like this, but you'd have to get the HTML somewhere.
Yep. And I think there's a tool that'll just allow you to put any HTML into a Facebook page, but you need to have HTTPS. Like, so you have to have secure connections for all your images and all your form data. So you will need an SSL certificate to do that. So it does take a little, there is some stuff involved, but it is doable for sure. You kind of have to work with someone who knows what they're doing, or figure it out yourself, which is, probably worth educating yourself on some of these things. That's kind of what we did, and I showed you how to do this with lead pages. I just want to share some of the results people are getting with this. Someone put this on our blog the other day. They just sort of wrote this randomly. He said, "Consistent with everything else you guys are putting out, my webinar today had a 76% conversion overall. Best ever in the first time out with this kind of page." So he was using these principles. I want to make this sort of a case study for using these principles, right? Two-step opt-in boxes, blurred out mind maps, mobile responsive pages, collecting fewer fields rather than more fields, right? These are the kind of results people are getting when they do this. And then he had Justin Livingston on my blog respond, and he said, "Get used to these numbers, Tom. I've filled out many webinars and I've yet to see an opt-in rate below 73% to our own list. These are out converting any designs I spent years testing." Ryan Dice said this. He said, "A few weeks ago, I held a webinar and the registration page converted at 72%. This was by far the highest converting landing page I've ever tested." And so this just goes
I'm
to
trying to think of
show.
what our conversion rate was. I
It
mean,
was
we
like
had
in the
two separate landing
70s.
pages.
It was in the
Yeah, it was
70s,
ridiculous.
which goes to show that even with an audience of your size, I mean, I guess maybe it's not fair because you have just your you've built up such goodwill. Even people with massive lists are still getting results like this. I guess you're an exception. I want to be like, Pat Flynn got a 70% plus conversion rate, but you did, and I imagine that's higher than other pages you're getting on
Yeah,
your
I mean,
website.
the point is, creating this webinar, built buzz and excitement, but at the same time, I was able to collect, a lot of people who are on the webinar are, already on my list, which is awesome. Thank you. But, an extra, 1,500 people who weren't a part of my list are now on my list as a result of doing this webinar.
Wow.
And of course, if you can provide value, then, rewards will come after that. You give and then you get back. So, I mean, again, just the principles, the webinar, the registration page, two sign up opt or two step opt-in process. It's pretty incredible what's possible out there now. And tools like this obviously make it easier. But if you have a team of coders already, that they can do this for you too. The webinar thing especially, I would encourage you just to at least experiment with it. It's so incredible. I mean, I am on such a high right now, being here with you guys. I mean, there are 774 people here right now listening to
Wow.
us. And yeah, I don't expect right out of the gate if you're just starting out to get you'd get that many too. But if you can connect with the right people and know that you're going to provide value for somebody else's audience, you know, that person might be able to help you build your list, but because you're going to be helping their people too. And it's just, gosh, I mean, when you set that webinar and there's a date, you know, you're going to prepare for it. And a lot of people turn these webinars into courses. You know, Cliff Ravenscraft did that with learnhowtopodcast.com. His podcasting tutorial is actually part of a webinar that was chopped up and given away for free to help drive people into his podcasting A to Z course. Yeah, it just gets you to do stuff in a higher quality way. And then obviously I do the podcast and the videos too, but I'm really thinking about doing more webinars, you know, just for Q&As and stuff, maybe like once a month. I mean,
Yeah.
I mean, that'd be awesome. I love doing stuff like this.
You know, it's a really good way. You know, I think a lot of times people want to create a course or they want to teach something and they have like content block, like writer's block. And so they never do it. But when you set a date for a webinar, you kind of have to show up because you've made that commitment to be there. So it's a good way to deal with, it's a good procrastination hack, I guess. And it's kind of good for that. So the third tip is, and this is so awesome. This is so cool. This is, you kind of schooled me on this, Pat. Like I had always talked about this stuff, but I've never seen anyone implement it to the extent that you have. But the third tip is to don't squander your thank you pages. Okay. And so just to kind of show you what most people do with their thank you pages, I'll just show you this one blog. Like I was just searching the other day and I saw this blog. And it's like a Philadelphia real estate blog. And so if you opt in here, let me opt in.
Hopefully this isn't any of yours.
Yeah, hopefully. And if it is, hopefully you'll take our suggestion. So so when you opt in here, you just get this thing that says, an email was sent to you. Please find that email and, you know, continue with us or something like that. So it's just this, you know, kind of thank you, thanks for subscribing, which is what most people do is they just have this really boring, like, hey, there's some stuff coming to your inbox. That's what most people say. And it's really kind of a waste of real estate to do this, primarily because like the people who are most into you, right? If you're, I don't even like the word leads because people are people, but the people, the hottest people, the people who are most hot for you are the people who are on your thank you page. Let's just take a look at the path that someone takes to get to your thank you page, right? So among billions of pages that exist on the internet, if someone ends up on your thank you page, they first found your website, right? So among billions of pages, they found you. And they found you through SEO, or you know, maybe you did some pay-per-click or something, Twitter, social media, word of mouth, however they find you, it's a statistical miracle that they found you in the first place, that of billions of pages, they stumbled upon your website. So lucky you that someone's on your website in the first place. Most people get almost no traffic. So among billions of pages, they find you. And then they're one of the few people that land on your website, because most people who come to your website bounce, right? They just immediately leave. About 70% of people on the average website or so, about 70%, just leave. So they're one of like the 30% or so of people that don't just immediately leave, right? And in fact, they don't just not immediately leave, but they also find what you're saying valuable enough that they want to opt in, right? So they're one of the, let's say, I said 10%, that's high, but say like about with most blogs, it's about 2% of people opt in to the blog. So they find you among billions of pages, they don't leave, they stay around enough, they find enough value that they want to opt in, and then the second they opt in, you just send them to a page. If you're like most people, you just send them to a page that says, thanks for opting in, you know, thanks so much, okay, bye.
I mean, people who use AWeber, which I know most of my audience does, or even Constant Contact or MailChimp, you know, I know when people used to subscribe to my email list, they would go to an AWeber page that would just say, thanks for subscribing, an email is coming your way, and it would just, then they would just close the window and that's it.
Yep. Yeah. So it like ends the conversation. And so what I recommend you do is what Pat Flynn did. I just called you Pat Flynn. What Pat did, and do something like this. So let's go to actually our webinar registration. It was called, it's like at LeadPages.net for it. So it's like Friday. Okay. So if we opt in here, Clay. We are taken to a page that looks very much like the page you saw. And it asks you, it encourages you to do more. It says, we thank you for signing up for our online training event. You will get email confirmation soon, but in the meantime, here's what you can do now. One, like Smart Passive Income on Facebook. So he's taking, you know, the people who are most passionate, most excited about what you're doing, and getting them to connect with you on Facebook. Also, you are doing what so many people did, and you're getting people to actually share this webinar on Twitter. And I'm just going to pull up Twitter here. So everyone can see, but I got thousands of these notices from people that were saying, like, look at these. They're all the same. Hey, Pat Flynn and Clay Collins, I'll be attending your webinar. And then they click here. And then so many other people saw this, and it created a viral loop. And like, I could literally scroll down here, and there's like page after page after page of this stuff. Like, it just keeps on going. Like, Twitter won't even give me anymore. So this is from, you know, 23 hours ago. And let me just like scroll. So this is just stuff from the last 24 hours or 23 hours. So these are almost entirely, like, if you look here, it's like the exact same tweet. It just goes on and on and on and on and on.
A bunch of people are saying, I did that. Or there I am. I see me. Yeah, it was so, I mean, the way you do that, and I mean, the reason it works so well, and I actually used Bitly to keep track of those links, one for the Thursday webinar, one for the Friday one, and I got a combined almost 1,000 clicks between the two of them. So that's 1,000 clicks times however many followers that is, you know, how many new followers that is. I mean, that's how I've been able to also grow my list beyond what I already had on the list. But the way this works is, you know, if you click on that tweet button, Clay, so yep, people can see sort of what happens there. It opens up this sort of pre-filled out form on Twitter, and people just have to click a button. If you're already signed into Twitter, you won't even have to sign in. You just click a button. And the way you do that is you go to clicktotweet.com, and that's where you fill out the form and whatever it is that you want this to say automatically, and you press a button, and it gives you a URL. And that URL is what you put on the thank you page. And then to get the bit.ly, obviously, you go to bit.ly.com to shorten whatever the webinar link is or whatever it may be that you want other people to send other people to. So that is a really cool strategy that you should totally, totally use. I got a bunch of comments. Huge. This is crazy. I use Click to Tweet a lot more than I thought I would. I use that when I speak live, too. And I have a URL, patislive.com. Which when people go to, it actually goes to one of these pages where people can just push a button and say, I'm watching Pat Live, and then it has the hashtag of whatever presentation I'm using.
Nice.
And it gets people just to talk about me more. So definitely use this on a thank you page. The principles here, one, you gotta utilize your thank you page. Think one of the things I recently done is on my thank you page for my email list, because of the type of audience I have, I say, hey, if you want to start an email list of your own, click on this button to read my how to start a newsletter post. Before, I was just sending people nowhere, and that's how I've been able to generate, you know, a lot of views on that page, and of course, AWeber commissions on top of that. So just keep those principles in mind. I mean, this is crazy. So bit.ly for Suzanne out there, and a bunch of other people who are wondering that's where you shorten any long link to make it really short, so you can put it in Click to Tweet and not waste those 140 characters that you have.
Yep. And it's important with these kinds of pages that, you know, I just say as many pages as you can have that are mobile responsive, the better. So this page is mobile responsive. But I'm going to show folks how they can do this for our lead pages customers. A lot of we've got so many features now and different types of templates that I don't think everyone knows what exists. But we have here a thank you page, and it's pretty easy to customize. You could probably just write a, you know, just something from scratch and text as a WordPress post. If you wanted to, that could be your thank you page if you use WordPress. But if you want to use lead pages, you can, you know, you can just click on this logo and replace it with your logo if you want. And, you know, I might say, thank you, I don't know, for joining. My spelling is atrocious. The lead pages community. And I can have like a video here. I think you turn that off. A lot of times people don't want to
turn that one off.
Have to come up with a video. And you can, you know, set the page that people like to be your just, you know, your URL or the URL for your Facebook page. And right. Yeah. And then right here, you can say, you know, whatever you want people to do, you can do the click to tweet thing. One thing that we do is I really enjoy doing webinars. So I'll invite people to join a webinar after they opt in. So you take someone who literally only would have opted in, and you encourage them to get involved at a deeper level, right? So not only don't just opt in, but maybe like us on Facebook, maybe share something that we've done, maybe sign up for our
Download
webinar.
Something.
Yeah. I mean, these are literally the most active people. Like, can you imagine, like, if I always think of dating analogies when I think of marketing, because everyone kind of gets them. And and I struggled with this at one point in my life. I'm married now. But I remember, like, once this happened once in my life, I think it was when I was in high school. Unfortunately, it didn't happen in college when I actually wanted it to happen. But once in high school, this girl came up to me, and by some miracle, she came up to me and handed me her phone number. And I was like, I didn't even know what to do. I was pretty stunned. But like in that moment when she like handed me her phone number, that was like when she was like most interested, like in me, right? And when people come to your website and they opt in, that's like right then when they've given you their contact information, that is when they were most interested in what you're doing. That's when they're like most hot for you. And so why not encourage them to get involved at a deeper level and get them to maybe like you or get them to sign up for a webinar. You can go like, you know, an added webinar link right here.
Hey, thanks for your phone number. Would you like to join this webinar?
Yeah. Would you like to get on a webinar with me next week? Yeah. Friday, 6 p.m. I'll pick you up. And then you can go here and you can, you know, you can upload your image and I'll get my image here. And then we kind of have this cool signature font. So you can, I mean, you can, yeah, there's a lot of ways to do this. But so, you know, you can do this. And then I'll just call this Flynn TY page demo.
Yeah, can you imagine just giving away a cool little report there on the thank you page? Like, thank you for signing up. By the way, here's this awesome gift for you. I didn't even tell you about it, but since you're here, I'm going to give it to you for free, and then just download it. And we haven't even gotten into the what do you call it, the product, the digital distribution feature of LeadPages, where you know you can hook up a product and they'll deliver it for you. But I mean, we'll get to that. But I mean, just crazy.
Yep.
Gosh.
I mean, there's so many. You can really hook people up here, and you know, again, you can publish this to WordPress, to Facebook. You can download and put it on your own server. But this is actually, it's a live file. You know, we just generated this right now. This is a live page on the internet. And again, mobile responsive. I love making mobile responsive pages respond to me. I'm like, respond to me anyway. makes me feel powerful. So that's one kind of thank you page that you can do. And I've seen, you know, a lot of these done. But there's also another one that I like to do that's really helped us out and grown our business. So sometimes we offer things to download with blog posts. And so here's something we offered for people to download. And after they download it, the thank you page just says, I'll just read it to you. Thanks for signing up. Everything we promise will be sent to your inbox shortly. While you wait for your materials to arrive via email, we recommend you click continue below to learn more about LeadPages and what it can do for your business. So I'm taking someone who just opted in, and I'm saying, while you wait for the stuff to come to your inbox, check out what we have to offer. And then we send them to our sales page. So we actually get a lot more sales because right after someone opts in, we say, hey, you know, the thing we're giving you for free is on its way to your inbox, but you might as well check out the thing that we have to offer, like our main product. And this kind of thing has worked really well. And it's also grown our list quite a bit because we give something away with every single blog post now that we put out, which is which may be our next tip. So another option is you have your opt-in page and you send people to the thank you page, and then from the thank you page, you send people to the sales page, or you could rotate it. You can send some people, you could send them a free thing, or you can send them something else that's cool, or you can get them to maybe like you on Facebook, or you can send them to your sales page as well. Tip number four is to use podcasts to grow your list. And I was researching you, Pat, and I saw where Derek Halpern said this. I don't know what the percentage is now. I want to kind of hear from the, I was going to say from the horse's mouth, but that's not very flattering. You don't look anything like a horse. But
was that a sheep? I don't know.
I don't know what that was. But it says, back in early November, I was hanging out with Pat Flynn, and he said 20% of my readers said they found me on iTunes. So obviously, podcasts are growing your list and growing your audience. And I want to show people this trick that we have. It's kind of a cool tactic. And again, this isn't. I have a perfect illustration of what I want to share here. So it's not like you have to necessarily do this with lead pages. It just makes it kind of easy. But I created this page with John Dumas from Entrepreneur on Fire. And what this page allows you to do, this kind of landing page, is allows you to give something away to people who follow the steps on this page. So you can have something that you give away. Step one, it says, in order to get this, step one, subscribe to us on iTunes. So they actually have to subscribe on iTunes. And then two, review our podcast. And it says, give us the honest truth. So you're not like bribing people to lie. You're asking them for an honest review. And then after they've subscribed on iTunes and they've reviewed the podcast, they can opt in to get the free thing that you're giving away. So this is a really good way to encourage the things that actually get you ranked in iTunes, right? So you rank in iTunes when you get people to subscribe to you and when you get people to review you. And this is kind of on the honor system. There's no way to force people to do these things, but we've actually found that this works incredibly well. I got this testimonial the other day. Someone left it on a blog and they said, the podcast template with an exciting promo video and target advertising literally took our podcast to number one in iTunes while I was sleeping. People keep on asking us how we did it, and I scream lead pages. And the truth is, we're happy to take credit where credit's due. We did kind of work out this concept for the page with John Dumas, so he gets credit too. But the concepts are get subscribers and get people to review your thing and incentivize it if you can. And
you don't need lead pages to do that. You can create your own page that you could drive your podcast traffic to. But this is something I need to do. I have people go to my show notes and do these things, subscribe, review, but that's amongst all the other stuff on my website. My website's full of stuff to look at, and it's all distractions. I mean, this is okay, a landing page to do these steps 1, 2, and 3. I mean, it's no wonder John Dumas was able to beat out Dave Ramsey for the number one business podcast last week. So yeah, this stuff works. I'm going to do this too, and just have a nice short URL to drive podcast traffic to. Actually, it's funny, yesterday on the webinar I said I should pick up spipodcast.com, and then I jokingly mentioned how someone was probably going to get it and then try to sell it to me for much more than it's worth. Well, I got an email after the webinar saying someone got it, and I was like, oh man, this person is just like snake or whatever. But he was like, no, I got it so no one else would get it and would charge you more, so if you want it, you can get it at regular price. And I thought that was really, really cool.
That's awesome.
And then Clay, you turned around and just were very generous and saw that random act of kindness and did one of your own. You gave him a free lifetime copy of Lead Pages, which is, again, thank you. And I just wanted to share that story.
Cool.
Just because I think it's really cool.
Well, so the reason you shared that, though, and I think that's really good, is that you were saying that someone should take a page like this and put it on. Like, you should take this page and put it on spipodcast.com, and then in every episode you can tell people about what you're giving away, so that even when they're listening in the car, they can remember, hey, if I go to spipodcast.com, I can get this. And then you can send people to subscribe on iTunes and to leave a comment. So these are links that go to the commenting area and the subscribe area. And I think that's a really good tactic, is rather than saying like smartpassiveincome.com/podcast/whatever, just get a domain and use like WordPress or something, or just export this file and incentivize people to do these things and hook them up. And it's on the honor system. You're not requiring it, but you know, you're asking them to, and people do it when you ask them to. So it's cool. So that's the tip number. That's kind of a quick one, but tip four, use podcasts to grow your list. The next tip, you know, we talked about this extensively on the podcast, so I don't want to belabor this point, but I want to encourage everyone to create a resource guide landing page. So here's what I mean by resource guide landing page. This is basically an opt-in page where people opt in and they get a list of resources. So it says free report reveals the top 5 dirt cheap tools I use to create all my videos, including my $80 HD video camera. So it took me this is what kills me. Okay. It took me 3 minutes to write this headline. And when people opt in, I'll show folks what I give away when folks opt in. Like I literally just give away this, right? Just a list of resources. So it took me about 15 minutes to write up this list of resources. And it took me 3 minutes to write up this headline. And this is the highest converting, like evergreen, always available web page in our business. This has grown our business in terms of, or grown our list faster than anything else other than webinar registration pages. So in terms of just event or evergreen marketing, this is working the best. And just some tips here. On what works, this woman, her line of sight is boom. It's right to the opt-in box. So we've tested this, and when you have an attractive person and they're looking at, or even anyone actually, and they're looking straight at the opt-in box, that increases the opt-in rate because they're directly looking at the thing that you want them to do. And also,
if you go to socialtriggers.com, you'll see Derek has a similar strategy. He has a
nice
sort of abstract picture of a person's head, and the nose is pointing directly to the subscribe button too. So that totally works, and it kind of makes sense. I mean, if you're in a crowded place and everyone starts looking up at the sky, you're probably going to look up at the sky too, just to see what's up.
Yeah, it's social proof. And we've also tested this, and both men and women, this is crazy, I don't understand, like don't ask me to explain this, but both men and women convert higher on web pages with attractive women. So both men and women like stuff with attractive women. I guess that makes sense. Like women's magazines have women in them and men's magazines have women in them. So I don't know what that says per se. But anyway, this is like literally, other than webinars, this is the highest converting page we've ever used. And here's what kills me, is that I've spent a month before writing a free ebook that we gave away. And I've spent about 3 weeks creating a free course to give away. And yet this page where I give away just a list of resources that I wrote in 15 minutes, this page outconverts lead magnets that I spent an entire month creating. So there is no correlation between the amount of time it takes you to create a lead magnet and the opt-in rate. And so kind of the principle behind this is that people love tools, right? So all things being equal, people would rather acquire a tool than acquire a skill, right? We have this belief as human beings that if we only had the tools that the pros use, that we would get the same results that the pros get. And actually, in a lot of cases, that's true. And that's why the best-selling issues of magazines like Backpacker Magazine, Photography Magazine, Golf Magazine, the best-selling issues are the gear guides, right? Like, so the like for a photography magazine, for example, where they tell you the best lenses for newbies and the best tripods for this situation and the best cameras for low light and stuff like that. Or with running magazine, like what are the best trail running shoes? What are the best marathon running shoes? What are the best cross training shoes, right? Stuff like that. People love getting these gear guides. And so I want to, we're just going to release the winners of our competition, our headline competition. So these people.
For those of you who don't know, on the podcast that Clay was on, he said he was going to give away three lifetime memberships to LeadPages to people who left the best resource opt-in headlines on the podcast. And that podcast, for those of you who weren't there, I apologize, there wasn't, it's smartpassiveincome.com/session78 is where you can see those. And there's like 500 comments now. And you could still leave yours too, although you won't be eligible to win because we've already selected the winners. But it's a great exercise. Clay is going to come in for maybe a month or so and tweak what he sees and help you sort of craft your headline even better. So thanks for that, Clay.
Yeah, I made a commitment to tweak every headline or to leave a comment on every headline that was posted there. So I will do that. Give me a week or so to finish this up. There's a lot of headlines there. I think there's like, last time I checked, there was like 400 comments on that post. So these are the winners. These are those sort of the winning headlines that people submitted. So here's one. The top five. So basically anyone can generate one of these. You just have to figure out a list of resources for your market. So everyone sort of listed sort of a headline for a page like this that they could put up for their market. So here's one, the top five job getting resume templates in Microsoft Word format of this year. These are the resumes my clients pay hundreds of dollars for. So basically this would be the headline that this person would put right here on a page like this. They might have a different background, but this would be the image that they put here, or the headline that they put on this page. And a lot of people, when they entered, they said like the top five ways to become more healthy or something like that. And those types of headlines where you're telling people when you say six tips or five ways or 18 ideas, like the key to making this work is specificity. This person is so specific. They're saying the top five job getting resumes. So they're giving you an outcome. These resumes get you a job. They're telling you, they're not saying here are six ways to get a job. They're saying here are five templates. And they're even telling you the format that they're in, right? They're in Microsoft Word format. And he's saying that, and he's ascribing a value to them, right? My clients pay hundreds of dollars. So they're telling you the outcome it gets you a job. They're saying exactly what it is. They're not saying five ways or six ideas or three concepts. They're saying, you know, resumes. You're getting resumes in Microsoft Word format, and he's adding a value proposition. Other people pay hundreds of dollars for these. Here's another one. Free report reveals the top four free fundraising tools you can set up in less than 10 minutes to instantly double your school and club fundraising profits. Hint, 90% of fundraisers don't know about these. So this phrase free report reveals is proven. That's kind of proven copy. They're saying the top four fundraising tools, and he's saying how much time it takes and the result that it generates. And there's kind of this, it's piquing your curiosity. You're saying other people don't know about these. You probably don't either. And so a lot of people will opt into this kind of thing just to see if they know what these fundraising tools are, because they're making the claim that other people don't know what they are. So I kind of like this headline. This one is probably second place. This one is third place. And this one is my favorite. I think it's the favorite one I read. So Lie Hacker. The top five body language signals of liars. Hint, hack your lie detection skills by remembering FMEGS. Okay, so this is so good.
This headline, so good.
It's so good. So this person is saying, it's kind of catchy to say lie hacker because everyone's heard life hacker. So he's saying the top five, it doesn't say tools. They don't say the top five ways to know if someone's lying. They say the top five body language signals, right? They're getting specific. They're signing a number. They're telling you the outcome for being able to detect a lie. And they're leaving you this huge open loop. Hint, hack your lie detection skills by just remembering FMEGS. Like, I would opt into this just to be like, what the heck is FMEGS, right? And all this person has to do is type out what FMEGS means and maybe have some pictures on like one piece of paper, and they're going to get so many opt-ins. Like, I want to know where this is on the internet right now, just so I can opt in to get this report.
Right.
So these kinds of headlines work really great. And again, you can compile a resource like this in just a few minutes. So people are getting mad results with these. I don't want to go over, you know, a bunch of testimonials, but you know, it's more like case studies. But people are saying these types of resource lists are getting them like 71% of their opt-ins from their website. Juan Martitegui says this is, you know, 3x to 4xing his conversions by doing these kinds of things.
Yeah, I actually took action after hearing this tip on the podcast, and I created a free report of my own for the food truck site that I have. And I'm going to share with you first time, actually second time, because we did it last night. But this, I had to blur out the name because I'm still not ready to share it yet because I don't want it to affect the numbers. But this is the book that I created we put together to you know, give away to people to subscribe, and we're going to be giving this away during the pre-launch phase and also post-launch. The headline is not the exact headline we're going to use, and we'll probably be split testing it using lead pages. But you know, these are just six free social media tools to get people talking about your food truck. Like, I think, you know, even better, it might be six social media tools to get people talking about your food truck. Hint: all of them are free. Or something like that, or you're not using these, or something like that. So yeah, I mean, just I wanted to show you this just to give you a preview and show you that with the niche site tool, like, stuff is getting done. It's just really hard to share things when I'm trying to avoid sharing the exact URL. But you can see a little bit of what the logo might look like there. And gosh, I'm just so excited. I know, Clay, you're having a hard time not sharing what it is too, because you know. Man, it's going to be awesome. But yeah, I mean, I just showed this to you because this didn't take that long to put together. I just found tools that I know that food truckers would use, and I know they use social media because I've asked them. You know, so conducting the research is important too to understand what tools or resources they would use. But a lot of food truckers actually rely on social media heavily. So, you know, using my internet marketing experience, I could find tools that could help take that even further. So taking the same principles and applying that for yourself too to create a resource that you can give away. Highly recommend it.
Yeah, that's so awesome. So the sixth tip that I want to give to everyone is, and we're going to get this through this kind of quickly because I just want to honor everyone's time. But the sixth tip is to give something away with every single blog post. And let me just show you. I'll just show you. We just set this up like 4 days ago in Lead Pages. And if I go to template, or if I go to my pages here, I can show you the analytics from my own website. Let's see. So we started giving away something with every single blog post. And this literally, in the last week or so, has tripled our list growth. Okay, tripled our list growth. So what we typically used to do was on our website, or on a blog, we just had like this, you know, people could opt in, or, you know, maybe we had some things that we gave away, you know, to people, like a free tutorial, and people got into that. But then what we started doing is with every single blog post, we started giving away something that people could opt in for that was specific to that blog post, right? Specific to that blog post. So on this one, I'm giving away something that people can download. And so we stopped just having general lead magnets, but we actually created a lead magnet for every single kind of new blog post. And again, this has tripled our list growth. So here's some ideas. You can give away checklists that go with your blog post. You can give away PDF versions of your blog posts. You can give away worksheets. You can give away recipes. You can give away resource guides, right? So worst case scenario, the lazy way to do this is you can literally just take your epic blog posts and save them as PDFs and allow people to opt in just for those posts, you know, just for the text of the article, because we have this human desire to want to possess things. So if you tell people like five things they need to do to start a podcast, you can create a checklist around that and allow people to opt in just for that checklist. And we've automated doing this. You know, again, you can set this up in Aweber, and it takes a while. But what we've done in Lead Pages is we've allowed you to just very quickly give something away. So usually in Aweber, in order to give something away, you need to set up a new list, set up a new form for that list, create an autoresponder for that list, and do a whole bunch of other things. But with Lead Pages, you can simply upload something to LeadPages, upload your file to LeadPages, and find the file you want to give away that's in your account. Just select the file that you want to give away, and you can add the person to just your normal list. You can have everyone opt into the same list. You don't have to build a new form and a new autoresponder. You can just pick something from your LeadPages account and have LeadPages deliver the lead magnet for you. So if I go to this page, I do want to save it. Okay, so if I go to this page and I click save and I go to publish, I'm basically added to, in quotes, the house list. But when I opt in here, I'm added to the same list I was on before, but LeadPages handles delivering the lead magnet, or the, sometimes I call it like the opt-in bribe. So I'm going to find, here it is. So here's what was just emailed to me is this, it's just a free report. So I'm going to download this. Here's what was just emailed to me was this opt-in guide. So again, LeadPages will handle delivering these for you. So you don't have to set one of these up for every single thing you're giving away, because it takes about an hour. We found it takes about an hour to set this up for everything you're going to give away for using like AWeber. But if you use...
That's how long it took me. I mean, I give away eBooks the Smart Way currently to people who sign up for the list. And you know, I'm beginning to think maybe just giving that book away for free and doing some sort of smaller resource page. But people sign up to the list, they go to the thank you page, then they finally get an email, and that email links to a page that I created on the site that then has a download link to get it. But there you can just click a button and download it, which is awesome. And I want to say, I mean, giving away stuff on every post might seem kind of crazy, but I'll tell you that when I did greenexamacademy.com and I was focusing on that, I wanted to give stuff away on every sort of post or anytime I could. Tips, charts, worksheets, practice exams, checklists were probably the best thing. I have checklists on that site that were downloaded between 50 and 60,000 times, because people want to see the steps that they have to do. And if you really want your audience to take action, a checklist is huge. Whether you have that behind an opt-in form or not, I mean, just giving away a checklist will help your authority like crazy. And if you really want to help people out, I mean, just imagine someone downloading that, printing it out, it's branded to you, it's actually something they can feel, and they see unchecked checkboxes there. That's something psychologically that'll want, people want to check off. And so, to get your audience to take action, to get them to believe in you more and understand that you're trying to help them out, a checklist specifically is huge. So if you write a post and there's an opportunity to do that, and I should have one for like my podcasting tutorial, for example, imagine how much more value that would provide.
Yep. And so now what we're doing is like in every single blog post now, because it only takes us a few seconds, we just upload the file to LeadPages and create a landing page, and we give something away now in every blog post. And it only takes us a few seconds to set up. So I have one other tip about using magic buy buttons, but I want to answer that during the Q&A, just because I want to make sure that everyone, there's some people who are like, hey, just let us know about the offer for LeadPages. So I just kind of want to recap what we've covered. So tweak one, optimize your 404 pages. Tip two, start doing webinars. They're converting incredibly well and are an amazing way to grow your list. Forget anything the actual webinar does for you and just focus on list growth at first. Use podcasts to grow your list. And again, get subscribers and reviews and incentivize that. Create a resource guide landing page. Tip six, give something away with every blog post, and we'll cover tip seven in a bit. So I want to just say something really quickly about why I created LeadPages, and why our team of 18 people created LeadPages. We did it because we saw so many amazing people who had brilliant products to give to the world, but who were being beaten by people with inferior products but better marketing. We saw businesses rising up that were marketing organizations with crappy products that were beating out well-intentioned people with amazing products. And so we wanted to create a conversion lab where we could handle the conversion piece for folks so that they could just focus on delivering value. And so we wanted to create a conversion lab where we could take research across our entire platform and put it in the hands of everyone. So it's really kind of we're really proud of what we've done, and we're proud of the results that we're getting. Like, literally, our webinar registration pages have not lost a split test. Our pages are just out converting the competition. We're even out converting people who have entire huge marketing departments. And so I did this because I wanted fundamentally to level the playing field. And so I want to offer everyone an opportunity to join us today and join this group of people, this smart passive income community that is embarking on this journey together to implement these changes in their business. And so I want to encourage you to go to leadpages.net/Pat.
Weren't there a couple new templates that are added to LeadPages?
Oh, I am so excited about this. So here's another these templates that we just added.
And then we'll get into the magic buy button next.
Yep.
We do that?
Yep. Okay. So we blatantly stole these from you with your permission. So we ethically ripped you off, if you will.
See you at the top.
Where is it? It's not, I don't want to say. Okay. So the first thing that we did is, the first template that we have here is, this is based on, and it's mobile, it's responding right now, which is why it looks like this, but like, so the first thing we did is, if you go to, where is it, like, Pat Flynn here, hold on. So it's like patflynn.me/ is it let go?
Yeah.
So if you go to patflynn.me/let go, you'll see Pat Flynn's book for his ebook. And so we added a page to Lead Pages that is here, I'll just publish this. So we got to name it. So Pat Flynn ebook template demo or something like that. So we'll save this. And the way this page works is it's based off what Pat did here, and we'd like to think that we added some bells and whistles to it, but it's basically a book for Kindle authors and ebook authors. And it, you know, here you can see Pat with his Let Go book, but so you can have like an about the author section, and it kind of scrolls to different parts. You can have like different things going on, but you can also use this to build your list. So if you click here to subscribe, to subscribe to my newsletter to get 100% free chapter from the book. So
I don't even do that, but I should. There's a podcast coming out with Jeff Goins that talks about this type of stuff, and I don't even do that yet, and I should have done that. So you guys made a better page than what I have. You know, even if you don't have Lead Pages, you know, go to my Let Go page, and you could just steal that template.
Cool. So that's the first one that we added, and that's available in Lead Pages. The other one that we added was based on his, I want to say the name of the site, but I can't.
Oh, I thought you were going to.
I really want to. So here it is. And this is, I keep on wanting to say it. So this is sort of it's mobile. It's responding right now, which is why it looks like this. But, here, I'll just save this page. I'll call it, I want to call it something, Pat Flynn. I'll just call it truck demo V2 or something like that. So I'll save this, and
so you get an idea of what the page is gonna, or what the site's gonna look like.
Right, and you can change out.
Definitely a team.
It's a launching soon page, and you can change the background, and you can change the image, and you can change basically everything about this page. You can change. So this is just a starting point, and it's anyway. So this is just what Pat is using to build his email
collect
list.
Leads, yeah, before the site goes up.
Yep. So that's kind of cool. We even took out, I don't know if your corporate name here is, we even took that out to protect your identity, but I think that's on all your websites.
Well, now people will find it, so thanks. No, I'm just kidding.
So we added these templates, and I think that just goes to, it just speaks to what we do with Lead Pages. Every single week we're adding new templates. that are available to our customers. So I think right now there's like 60 templates. Like if you could just, I mean, you can just scroll and scroll and scroll and scroll and scroll and scroll and scroll and
And you're
scroll.
adding more all the time. I'm on your tail to add more. And I know a lot of people are too, because there's certain things that I want, and that I don't have the ability to create on my own. I mean, that's the purpose of this. A couple of people are like, "How are you getting negative comments? This software is saving my butt because I can't afford a designer and I can't do this on my own," which is exactly why I have it and why I wanted to share it. And I'm always like, "I need a page that does this." And I'll talk to Clay, and he'll be like, "Okay, well, let's talk about it. What do we want it to look like?" and things like that. So, yeah, we're going to keep adding stuff. And yes, should we get into the magic buy button? Again, this is something that can be done in Lead Pages, of course, but it could be done on your own too. There are scripts, I believe, that are available out there that will allow you to do what we're about to show you. And it's really cool.
So I'll definitely show that. So there's and again, let's see, we're getting on two
Sorry, I
hours.
totally
We
interrupted you. Yeah.
oh no, yeah, whatever. We're getting on 2 hours, and just, I mean, well, anyway, just whatever. I'm not gonna even say it because I don't want to sound pitchy, but just know that we're gonna end at some point soon. We do want to answer as many questions as possible, but so the next point. Or the one of the points that I missed, because I wanted to bring this up on the thing, on the webinar, is about using magic buy buttons. So I'll just kind of show you what a magic buy button is, because a lot of people don't know what they are, and I don't even know if that term is like an industry-wide term. So I'm going to go to one of our sales pages, and it's actually a video sales page, and again, you can change the logo, you can change the colors, you can change the fonts and stuff. But what this area right here, we found that, I mean, this isn't our data. We actually got this from Digital Marketer. But we found that if we don't show this area of the page until the call to action part of the video happens, that we can get a that in a lot of cases we can double the conversion rate. So let me just put a video in here so I can illustrate what's going on. So I'll just go to leadpages.net, and I'll just grab this video. Right.
Ooh, responding to a lot of questions.
Awesome. So I'm just going to grab this video. I'm going to go to, oh, let's see, what does it need to be? I'm going to click here on embed. 857. So we'll set this to 857. So we'll just grab this, and so if we just grab this video, so we put like a YouTube video here, and like let's say you have a 5 minute video, and during the first 3 minutes, like let's say you're a health coach, and the first 3 minutes you're explaining your philosophy to health coaching, you're describing what you provide, your approach, your background, and in the last 2 minutes you're telling people what you have to offer and the price point and the bonuses and maybe any kind of risk reversal or guarantee. In that case, you would wait until you're actually encouraging people to purchase your thing or offering it to them. You're waiting until you get to the offer to show this button. And if you wait until you get to the offer to show this button, we found, and a lot of other people found, that you can get a 200% increase, a 200% lift in your conversions. So what you would do is you, and I'll just illustrate how this works so people know. Usually you'd set this to like maybe like 3 minutes into the video or something like this, but I'm just going to set this for 12, like for 12 seconds, just to illustrate this. So I'm going to call this Flynn VSL Demo V2. So I'm going to click save. So the way this works is you'd take this page, and you'll just see what happens here. So basically, the video's playing, and 12 seconds into this, the button's gonna appear, right? So basically, we've waited. I mean, this would be like later in the thing, but you would wait until you actually offer the product to show the buy now button, just like it showed here. So again, it doesn't appear at first, but when you get to the offer part of your video, that's when you would time it to appear. So you would just figure out,
Thank you.
So you would just figure out when in the video you make the offer and set that to be the time when the buy now button appears. And again, that can double your conversion rate. So like for this one, it's set for 12 seconds, but realistically, it, you might set it for like 4 minutes and 12 seconds or whenever you go into the offer. You can also do this with, leave page. Okay. You can also do this with opt-in pages. So we have, for example, opt-in pages where the opt-in box doesn't appear until you tell it to. So this one, let's just put this in here. Oh, shoot. Okay, so let me just grab this video. Let's go. Edit lead page. So I'm just going to grab this video code and throw it into this one. And we can set this. I'll set this to be the right dimensions, 850 by 478. 478. Okay. So so I could set this so that the opt-in box doesn't appear again until the part of the video where I encourage people to opt in. So I'm going to save this. I'll call this Flynn PSL opt-in demo V2. And I'll click on save. And I'll go to publish. I'll just grab this. And here you can see that, again, the opt-in area doesn't appear at first. So we wait till we actually get to when I would make the opt-in offer. And that's when this appears. So we wait until we've actually gotten to that part of the video to offer it. And, you know, the way I think of this is really kind of like, again, I kind of, maybe it's just my juvenile way of thinking, but I kind of think of this like dating. Like you wouldn't just go up to a bar and immediately ask someone, you know, immediately close the sale, right? You wouldn't just like immediately ask someone for a phone number or something like that. You'd wait until you established rapport, made a connection, and talked to someone for a bit before you maybe asked for their phone number. And so the principle behind this is really illustrated right here. It says magic buy buttons. When it comes to variables that whisper, rarely do you find one that doubles conversions, but the magic buy button does. When the order button isn't visible when the prospect first arrives, your video sales page looks like regular content, not a sales page. When your video sales letter reaches its call to action, shazam, your buy button magically appears. But prospects have kept an open mind throughout your video. So basically, people have kept an open mind throughout, and then when you actually come to your offer, that's when you show it. So they've kept an open mind the whole time. So that's kind of the principle behind a magic buy button. And again, that's just standard with a lot of the LeadPages templates. If you're not a LeadPages customer, you know, you can hire a coder, or you can get a script maybe that allows a certain portion of your page to be like this.
I saw an internet marketer selling a script way back when, like a couple years ago.
They're probably selling for a couple $100, right?
Yeah, exactly. but I mean, you could hire someone for much cheaper, actually.
Probably.
But anyway, it's just, again, the principle, when people come to the site or watch your video, they don't want to be thinking it's a taking page right away. And it's you know, you want them to be involved and engaged with the content before they sort of have this pre-notion idea that this offer is here, that's all, you know, bright shiny button, whatever. So that's the sort of motives behind this strategy. Clay, I hope you don't mind if we begin to wrap things up. Because we're already at the 2-hour mark. A lot of people have to go. I appreciate all of you staying on. There's still 500 on now. Thank you, Clay.
Yeah,
anything
totally.
Else?
Nope, that's it.
Yeah, so I just want to wrap up and just say, you know, first of all, on behalf of everybody here, Clay, thank you so much for creating this offer. But not, you know, beyond that, just coming on here and providing value and sharing the information. I hope everyone took notes. I saw a couple of people who took double digit pages of notes, which is a great sign, meaning that you know, they got a lot out of this. Hopefully, you've written down some actions that you're going to take based on the principles here. Yep. Again, thank you all for your support. I love you all so much. I'm falling in love with this whole webinar thing. I think I might. I might do this, and you know, I'm going to put everyone's hands down here in the chat room so I can see how many people are interested. But if I were to do a monthly webinar, hey, I didn't ask you to put your hands up.
People are like, yes, whatever you want, Pat. Yes, we're interested.
If you're interested in maybe perhaps if I were to do a monthly webinar and just do like a Q&A every month where I can talk and interact with you like this, how many of you would be interested? There's a little tool in there on the side of your control panel where you can raise your hand. Okay. So obviously that's something you guys would be interested in. And, you know, those ones wouldn't be about a specific product. You know, maybe they would be themed or not, but, you know, that would just be there to show you. Or you know, I feel like a webinar is a fantastic way to provide value, and I forgot how awesome that is or how powerful it is to do that. So remember that for you and your business. Do webinars. They're not only good for creating your list, but also helping your audience be engaged. I mean, you've been here the whole time. Thank you. And so that should just be obvious proof. So I'm definitely going to consider doing these monthly now, like Q&As where we can chat and hang out. You know, I just love the real-time interaction with you guys, keep you guys posted about what's going on. And yeah, I mean, just thank you so much for being on. I hope you got value out of this. If there are any questions, concerns, criticisms, I am more than happy to take them if they are respectful. If you're just going to call me a name, don't waste the time. I'm not going to email you back or get heated up about it. You know, I was bullied in school. I know how to handle those types of things. But if you're respectful and you have comments, if you feel there are things that I or Clay could do better, you know, if you feel a certain way and you want to talk about it, I am more than happy to hear from you. Pat@smartpassiveincome.com. If you enjoyed it, or even if you didn't, you know, give us a shout out on Twitter. I am @PatFlynn and Clay is at Clay Collins with two L's. Just thank you guys so much for sticking around. And if you have any follow-up questions, let us know. And any final words, Clay?
Yeah, I was thinking about this whole Pat Flynn be everywhere thing. And I was thinking about like webinars and you, and I'm just thinking about the future. Like I just had this image of like when I was thinking about you, like podcasts, YouTube, the blog, speaking at conferences, webinars. And I just got this vision of the future of like waking up in the middle of the night and this like Pat Flynn hologram staring at me. I'm like, shit, this guy is everywhere. Oh, I didn't mean to curse. Sorry. Crap, this guy is everywhere. Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Anyway.
Well, once the hologram technology comes around, I might use that too, although that'd be kind of scary. Webinars are awesome.
My final words really are just thanks to everyone who was here. We sent out the workbook. I hope you filled it out while you were on this webinar. We're going to send out the mind map later today. Kind of recapping the things that were covered here. You know, I know we made an offer for lead pages and there are these bonuses that are available while this webinar is happening, but please also remember what we covered, because everything is applicable regardless of the tools that you use. So I designed this webinar around the principles and because I happen to have a software company, we wanted to make sure that the software did everything or automated the things that would be useful to you. But it started out with these principles, and I want you to remember these. So tweak number one, get those, optimize your 404 pages. Tip number two, do webinars. They're just an amazing way to connect with people. Even if you just do Q&A, you don't even have to come up with any content at all. Just interact with people. Tip three, don't squander your thank you pages. You saw the viral list growth using that click to tweet tool. You know, use podcasts to grow your list, and on the podcast, incentivize subscribers, encourage everyone to subscribe. I think the first time I left a comment on John Dumas's podcast, he was like, hey, would you mind subscribing to my podcast and leaving a comment? And I was like, this guy gets it. And it's no wonder that he's got like the top podcast right now. Tip five, create a resource guide landing page. They're easy to create. There's no excuse for you to not want to create one of these. Tip six, give something away with every blog post. Again, even if it's just a checklist or even just a PDF. And seven, use magic buy buttons. But I think the whole principle with magic buy buttons is really the same principle as the two-step opt-in process, which is it's all about timing. So many people think conversion is just about the message, but it's as much about timing as it is about the message, right? You, with a two-step opt-in, you're only showing the opt-in box when people click on that button and ask for it, right? With the magic buy buttons, you're only showing the magic buy button when people are actually at that part of the video. If they leave in the first 30 seconds, they're not going to see the button, right? So you're timing what you're doing and your calls to action with where people are psychologically at the time. So it's about timing. So please take these away, regardless of whether or not you kind of join the LeadPages family or not. Please, please, please remember these principles, and we're going to email out a mind map that sort of illustrates a bunch of these things. So please remember the principles, and I want you to know that I absolutely honor and respect what you're doing. I hope that the six people who got free lifetime memberships to LeadPages use the heck out of them. And to everyone who listens to the podcast, I will be going in and individually tweaking and giving you feedback on your headline. So again, just know that, remember when we went over the top headlines, if you leave a comment on Pat's podcast, I will go in and personally review all of those. And it might take me a couple weeks here, but I will do it. So please know that as well. And so I just want to thank everyone. And I want to thank you, Pat, for this opportunity. It's a huge opportunity to be able to work with you both in as an advisor and on this webinar. And we're just really grateful.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much for everything. Thank you. I mean, the biggest thanks should go out to all of you who are still here and listening.
Absolutely.
You guys rock. I wouldn't be here without you, obviously. So I'm going to do everything I can to give back to you. I can't say anything else, but thank you, and I love you. All right, let's finish up. All right.
I'm gonna just hit the button, close button. Just tell me. Just say.
Always the weird part.
Just say engage. No, because it's to everyone listening. Like, I have the webinar is on my GoToWebinar account, but it's Pat's webinar. Like, he's the host. So Pat, why don't you just say like click or something like that when you want me to click the exit button?
I was just thinking of. I remember I was in a mastermind group a long time ago with a bunch of people. One person said that on webinars, they would pretend to finish up, but not really do it, so everyone is still there, and then have like a side conversation that would help their authority even more. I thought that was kind of sneaky and kind of, I don't know how to feel about that. Like, if we just was like, man, wasn't that good? Like, I can't believe how much value we had, you know, like, and knowing that they were still there, but pretending not to. I think that's kind of...
That is sneaky. Kind of like if you're like, all right, it's over, Pat. Like, man, that went so well. Everyone was just loving it. Man, it's so great that we did this. And look at all the thank you emails that came in. Man, that was just a great time. And then like pretended like we didn't know it was still going
on. But people do that. I mean, it's so crazy that people would think to do that on purpose. It's just crazy.
I heard someone, in terms of webinar tips, I heard someone talk about like how to get social proof on webinars. Here's something. I mean, I would never do this, but like these are the things that marketers, like, you know, when you go to conferences, you hear people talking about this stuff at bars. So like someone was saying that even if you have like five people on a webinar, that one way to build social proof is at the very beginning, you can say, hey, to everyone, you know, who's on this webinar, just to show enthusiasm, I'm going to unmute the lines and everyone starts screaming. And even if you have like five people screaming at the same time, it sounds like hundreds of people are screaming at the same time. So it sounds like there's a whole bunch of people on the webinar, even if there's only a few. So like, that's another thing that people do. What's another thing that people do? A lot of times people will say, I know all the tricks, but we don't do them. Like, I believe in knowing the dark arts, but not using them ever. A lot of people will like get this random name generator and list a list of fake names that of people that they're saying are buying the product. So they'll like, they'll kind of be like on QVC, thanks to Suzanne from like Illinois and Bob from wherever. And then a lot of people generate a huge list of questions because they know that, like, I don't know. Anyway, there's so much slime out there, and I'm glad. Well, anyway, never mind.
Anyway,
I'll stop.
You got some
listening
interesting...
bad things to do.
No, again, thank you guys so much. We'll just close it up, and Clay, if you wanted to recap after and talk about how it went and maybe what we could improve on, that'd be awesome.
Awesome. Yeah, I look forward to that.
Cool, guys. Take care, everybody. Thanks.